What's going on, YouTube world? Welcome back to a little bit, man. Gaming, bringing you a review for the all new Superman and Lois, the first episode, which is just titled Pilot. But first things first, if you could hit that like, subscribe, share, and the notification button. Also, leave a comment down below what you thought of the first episode of Superman and Lois. Do you think it was good? Did you think it was bad? You know, tell me what you didn't like and what you did like. But yeah, let me know in the comments down below. Also, for those who are not subscribed, subscribe. I know you're not subscribed, so subscribe. And those who are subscribed, share. And I can't stress enough, share. So I could get my name. So we could get this train chugging along fastly and greatly. Get my name out there. And, you know, let's have fun. With that being said, let's get into it. Yeah, not really a synopsis. This is just a pilot episode. But it just says that Superman and Lois return to idealistic Smallville is set to be upended by mysterious strangers. So, yeah. And then, like, the bigger... Oh, I did the overall... It's an overarching narrative for, like, the whole show as a whole. You know, it just says after years of facing supervillains, monsters, and alien invaders, the world's most famous superhero, the Man of Steel, aka Clark Kent, and comic books famed journalist Lois Lane come face to face with one of their greatest challenges at dealing with being working parents in today's society. Complicating the already daunting job of raising two boys, Clark and Lois worry about whether their sons, Jonathan and Jordan, could inherit their father's Kryptonian superpowers as they grow older. Returning to Smallville to handle some Kent family business, Clark and Lois are reacquainted with Lana Lang and her fire chief husband, Kyle Cushing. The adults aren't the only ones discovering old friendships in Smallville as the Kent sons are reacquainted with Lana and Kyle's rebellious daughter, Sarah. Of course, there is never a dull moment in the life of a superhero, especially with Lois' father, General Samuel Lane, looking for Superman to vanquish a villain or save the day at a moment's notice. So, let's break this down. Superman and Lois, for at least the first episode, is interesting. I'm going to keep watching and see how it goes. It is interesting. It is very much what I thought it was going to be. And like they said, this is not just about Clark being Superman, you know, going around saving the day. This is also about the parallel struggle of being not only Superman but being Clark Kent as a working man and raising two sons. One is Jordan and it's Jonathan and Jordan. Now Jordan, I think, is actually the comic book son of Superman, while Jonathan is not. I think Jonathan, I want to say Jonathan is the one made for the television series, and Jordan is the actual, it's like in the comic books, I think Jordan is the one who takes over being Superman. Yeah, I think, okay, yeah, it's Jonathan. Yeah, Jonathan is the one who ended up taking over for Superman and becoming Superboy, and then later on Superman in a sense. I had to find it in here in my notes. But I think Jonathan and Jordan, it's the one that's not in the comic books, but he's the one who ended up developing the superpowers. So what I think of the show as a whole, it starts off, like I said, it starts off with the one thing I will say, I like the little touch they do at the beginning of the episode where Superman is wearing the Kingdom Come Superman outfit. And for those who don't know, Kingdom Come was this run of the Superman, and not only just Superman comics, but it had like Batman and some of the other heroes involved in it. But the main thing about the Kingdom Come Superman and Batman was that these were veteran, jaded, older versions of Superman. Like, Superman, though he aged slower on Earth because of the yellow sun. I guess like when Kryptonians are on Krypton, if Krypton never was destroyed, they age like regular humans. But when they're on Earth because of the yellow sun, they aging is significantly slowed. Like they could stay, they basically would be young or stay young looking once they get to a certain point for a longer duration than normal humans can do. And in Kingdom Come, Superman, while it is finally reaching the point of his life where he's starting to finally get gray hair and starting to actually get old, but he still looks kind of young. But now you can tell he's fine. His even for Kryptonians on Earth, he's starting finally getting to the old part of his aging, because now he got like gray side lengths. But Batman is a very old and jaded Batman, but he's not like old to where he can't be Batman. He's just an older version, like almost like Batman and Superman is in particular are like older versions of themselves. And Batman in particular don't really like Superman. That's like where they get the Batman versus Superman movie. That's where they get that from the Kingdom Come Batman, who at first hated Superman because he thought he was a threat to humanity himself. But and the Kingdom Come, the thing about the Kingdom Come Superman, when it brings you back to the costume he wore at the beginning of the episode, when you first see him, he wore the Kingdom Come Superman suit. And the Kingdom Come Superman suit is basically, it still looks the traditional, it's a traditional blue and red, you know, but the S symbol is different. Instead of being like the S symbol being red with a yellow background, is like I'm trying to find it. Yeah, instead of the Superman symbol being an S with a yellow background, it's an S with a black background, and it's similar. It's because in this universe, this Superman has gone through a great deal of loss. In this universe, you know, he lost Jimmy, Lois, and a handful of other people he loved so much that he decided that, you know, it wasn't going to turn him dark, but it made him appreciate the fact that even in the darkest of moments, there was still hope. And he wanted his symbol to symbolize that. So that's why he changed the symbol for having a yellow background behind the S to a black, because he wanted the black to symbolize that even with, like I said, even with the darkest moments, there's still hope. And I like that they actually made a little nod and reference to that Superman, because they in the Crisis crossover, which that would lead into my negative of the show, one of my negatives. But it did, in the Crisis crossover episode, they did have the Kingdom Come played by the dude who played Adam. He once again returned to Superman, but he played the Kingdom Come Superman. And what's nice, it's cool to see that they also made him so that he also had the Kingdom Come suit, but without the background story of Kingdom Come Superman. So the show is very interesting, and it's showing Clark go through the struggles. You know, it very much goes with today of, do people read newspapers anymore? Like, is there even use for newspapers and journalists and all that type of stuff? And if so, you know, they have to make budget cuts. And that's one of the struggles that Clark goes through, because, you know, him and Lois, after a day of saving people, they struggle, you know, they struggling with should they tell their kids the truth that's about Clark, that he's really Superman and an alien, that they are half human, half alien. And also, you know, Clark not really being at home because he's out saving the day and stuff. You know, they in his struggle with his children, because his two sons now, they're basically like distant from him because he's been out saving the world so much that he's pretty much lost touch with them, and the struggle and the notions that should he be home more to be with his children. So the what this show points out to, it shows Clark and as a very much human, even though he's alien, and but there's still always a villain. There's still always somebody to do it. And this episode, it had a villain who was going to be a major villain throughout the season, and Captain Luther. And Captain Luther, or before you find out he's Captain Luther, you know, he's basically this dude who knows that Clark Kent is, who knows, you know, Superman is not, I don't think he knows that Superman is Clark Kent, but he knows that Superman is Kal-El. He knows enough to know that Kal-El is his real, is Superman's real name and all that type of stuff. So it's yet to be seen he knows that he's Clark Kent, but he does know at least who Superman, you know, his superhero name is Superman, but he knows Superman's real name is Clark, is Kal-El. And you also see, you get to know his sons. You get the one son is the model son, you know, perfect in, on his way to having, you know, all, he, on the football team, he's naturally gifted, has skills, a skill set, and very gifted athlete, very gifted personality. He's the flamboyant playboy son that you respect. But then it's the other, then it's Jordan. Jordan is the more, is the kind of messed up kid. You know, he got his, you end up finding out that he suffered from his severe anxiety problems, and he's got self image issues. He, and you know, he's like the more weird, awkward, nerdy character. And he's awkward, he's nerdy, but the big dilemma between them two that Lois and even Clark talks about is that which one of the sons is going to end up having powers, which one not. And even, and I want you to keep this in mind, appearances could be deceiving, but you know, their belief in their mind, the skills that Jonathan displays is so solid that he might be the one having powers. While Clark had both of them tested, and it says that Jonathan is the likely one to have powers, while Jordan is likely not to have powers. Because, you know, the half human, half Kryptonian thing, they won't. One of them will end up taking after Lois, and one of them won't. So that's a dilemma that goes out to the episode. It even plays out when they had a funeral. I won't tell you who died, but someone died. They had to go to a funeral, and an incident happened when they were trying to reset the router, and Jordan falls from trying to reset the router, and a heavy beam, pole beams that were, if it fall on you from a high spot, it's going to kill you. It's getting ready to fall on Jordan, and Jonathan dives on top of him to protect him. And you know, Sarah, which is Lon Lang's, which I should have mentioned too, that at the funeral, you know, Clark is reacquainted with Lana and Lana's husband and their daughter, their two daughters, and Jordan, so that Jordan has a crush on Sarah, and Jonathan kind of has a crush on her, or kind of, you know, or want to be more of a playboy and try to get her too, but you know, they go a different route, and so that Sarah was more interested in Jordan than Jonathan, and which, you know, Jonathan was like, oh, okay, that's not, you know, that's unusual, but hey, you know, go for it, bro. But yeah, they both try to use the Wi-Fi, but the Wi-Fi, they end up realizing something wrong with the Wi-Fi, so they go in there and need to see that the Wi-Fi motor needs to be reset. So Jonathan climbs on these, Jordan climbs up to go reset it after getting Sarah's number, you know, feeling good. He wanted to go reset the modem himself. They tell him to be careful, but he ends up slipping, losing his footing, and knocking over these beams. He hits the dirt first. The beams get ready to fall on him, and Jonathan dives on top of Jordan, And Sarah runs out to go get Clark, and everybody tells them that Jordan and them might have been hurt. And Jonathan, you know, Clark, you going and running towards the barn, and then when out of sight, using his powers to unearth Jordan and Jonathan, he sees that they are pretty much okay. Where symbolizes that at least one of them does have powers, because they you hear Lois and them talking about it. That in order for them to come recover with just mild concussions and a couple of scratches and bruising, one of them have to have powers, as they suspected. But they, you know, they, like I said earlier, they got their suspicions of who it is, but we're not sure who it was. And then you get Jordan's suspecting something's up, because they always telling them every time they go to grandma's house not to go into the barn, you know. So what's in the barn? They fear that their parents are lying to them about something, which led Jordan and Johnny to finding finding Clark's spaceship hidden in the barn. And they confront Clark and Lois about the ship. After Lois and Clark finds out that their grandmother's house, or Clark's mother's house, is up to them. Is the bank would either buy it from them, or they would pay the bank to keep it in the family, you know. And at this point in Clark's life, him, Lois, and the kids live in Metropolis, and now they have a decision to make: do they sell the farm, or do they keep the farm? And on their way back from talking about it, then finding out what Lana and them, because Lana works at the bank that holds the deed to Clark's farm. We also find out, I forgot to mention too, that Morgan Edge is going to be playing a significant role in Superman Lois. He's the one who takes over the Daily Planet, and because of the whole debate about whether we need journalists and the people not read the newspaper anymore, everything's via internet, that we see that people are getting fired at the Daily Planet. And, you know, they get in, they find out that this one of their coworkers has been fired because everybody's in gloom and doom. They ask one of the coworkers what's going on. They said people are getting downsizing, people are getting fired because of the lack of people reading newspapers and stuff, which is very much real worldish. And Clark is also called into the office and find out that he was also fired himself. And now Clark is now an unemployed man who has nothing but his superhero gig, which now is hard to do, because now since he's know that he won't be a journalist, he got fired. It's hard to make up lies to his sons. So that's another dilemma they deal with. But it all puts to rest when they discover the spaceship, which leads Clark to having to reveal, finally agreeing to reveal the true nature of the spaceship, revealing that, you know, he's Superman. As you see in the trailers, they like, no, we would have known that you're Superman. We've seen Superman. Which brings me to my first, and it's probably like a common thing, it's just silly, really, the glasses. He has on the glasses, and yet they act like they never seen their father without glasses, so they can't tell that he's Superman because he has glasses. The glasses, I always thought that was a silly thing in the Superman comic books. Even in the comic books, the TV show, every form of media that Superman has been in, the glasses is what people, you know, without glasses, oh, he's Superman, but with the glasses, oh, it's Clark Kent. But y'all can't tell the difference. It's just Clark Kent without glasses. Like, apparently to everybody in the Superman world, they are oblivious to the fact that it still looks like Clark Kent just without glasses. But apparently that to them, he looks different without glasses and with glasses. But even their sons is a ploy of this device, where they say they seen Superman, they would have known he was Superman, and he takes off his glasses and they like, oh my god, they're shocked to realize that their father is Superman because he looks like Superman without the glasses. I'm like, seriously? That kind of, it's silly. It's I have to count him, because it just made me really like, they really gonna go with that? Like, I would accept it anything other than the fact that his sons couldn't recognize that he was Superman because of his glasses. But he takes off his glasses and displays his powers. He picks up the family truck easily and flies in the air with it. And you know, the kids are basically angry that both Lois and Clark lied to them about him being Superman. So being angry with the parents, and you know, all the kids go to a party. Jordan goes to a party to meet up with Sarah, as Sarah invited him to a party earlier, which he got his number. And Jordan finds out that Sarah is just like him, kind of messed up, that she ended up taking pills. She almost took her mother's pills and killed herself. So she had to go to therapy just like Jordan did. And that they bond over the mutual messed up stuff, you know, their mental illness, if you will. They bond over that. And Jordan goes in for a kiss, which leads it to a fight because Jordan didn't realize that Sarah had a boyfriend. The boyfriend sees this and gets mad and fights with both Jonathan and Jordan. And it's at this point, one of the sons angry. That seeing his other brother getting beat up displays powers. And the first power that this son displays is heat vision, which causes an explosion, which breaks up the fight. But, you know, as a good notion from them, nobody saw the saw this son use the heat vision and cause the explosion. But the parents are shocked to find out that's what happened. That son finally displayed powers. And that was the first power the son displayed. And this son, once they talked, they had like this little family meeting. They talked with the son about it, and the son reveals that that's why they were so gung ho about. Find out what was going on, because they even knew something was up, that they didn't get hurt without a scratch. And it's revealed that it's because the son who had the ability was the one who took the brunt of the force of those pipes landing on them. And that was the son with the ability, and they vowed to help him with the transition and help him learn how to control and use his powers. And Clark finally bonded with his sons and finally gaining that much needed bond with his sons that he desperately needs. And Clark finds out that his mother wanted him to come home because of the house being about to be brought by him or sold to the bank. And you'll find out why this happens and how this comes, because if you see the episode, I don't want to spoil too much. So that's why I'm leaving it vague on which son has the powers and why Superman has to decide whether to sell the house to the bank or to get the buyout from the bank or buy the bank out and own the farm himself. And they end up deciding to stay in Smallville. This is why, if you keep up with it, that the show was going to be based in Smallville, not Metropolis, because they end up deciding that it's what's needed. That's why his mother wanted him to come home, because it's what's needed. She knew it was time, and it's what's needed for him to actually bond with his kids and have that bond that he needed with his kids. And the show ends basically with them finally bonding and deciding with the kids that they might stay. But it's a decision that they all have to make because they know the kids got school. Jonathan got football and all that type of stuff. He don't want to mess that up because he's like on track to almost having scholarships. But yeah, the show ends on a happy note with them finally look like they on the right track to becoming a true happy family. So overall, if I have to give the show anything, I give it 8 big ups, because it did what it needed to do to drive the plots and many things. You know, you got the villain being Captain Luther, you know, who was the one going around destroying these plants. And, you know, that if anything, I'm just sad and disappointed that they didn't mention Crisis, or the fact that, you know, Clark didn't have two sons at first. But that's it. Yeah, see you in the next video. Peace.